And welcome everybody here in Twitch chats and everybody on YouTube for the moment you've all been waiting for, at least the moment I've been waiting for. The new PC is up and running. Hopefully this is better quality on YouTube also. Y'all have to let me know in the comments if it is, and hopefully it's all working correctly and there's not the music, like we're playing music here on the stream. Hopefully the music's not getting played on YouTube also. But yeah, it's all up and going, and on my end it looks a lot clearer. Hopefully there's no lag issues. Again, y'all on YouTube, let me know if there are lag issues. If there are, I'll be sad. I really hope there aren't. I don't know what I'll do about it, but yeah, hopefully there aren't. But yeah, so I didn't really have time for with getting everything set up last couple of days. First, the last piece that I needed didn't come in until Tuesday night at 9:30 p.m. So that day was kind of wasted, and then took basically all Wednesday getting everything running, and of course, you know, trials, tribulations. But got the whole PC built. It's running now. It's Thursday. We're streaming. I didn't have really time to put together new decks. I haven't really looked too much at Magic the last couple of days. So I've been just focused on that and getting other things done around the house and stuff. And like, I was in the vet for a couple hours with Hawkeye because he was sick also this morning. But he's feeling better, and he's got like some vitamins to help boost up his immune system. Anyway, so we got four decks that we're gonna kind of, that we haven't played in a while, that we're just gonna run back, and they're four very fun decks, and hopefully they all do well. We're just gonna play them in ranked because we're starting a little bit late, because we're getting settings up and going and making sure everything's working with the stream. So we're gonna play like four matches in ranked instead of playing any of these anywhere else. But of course, we're playing fan favorite Orzhov Troll Knights to start with, a deck that I've played many, many times and probably my favorite deck right now. I'm not sure how it really fares with the post Mythic Championship metagame. Haven't really played too much post Mythic Championship metagame, so we're just gonna kind of play some games and just see what happens, and hopefully earn this Worthy Knight card style. How close are we to this Worthy Knight card style? I think we have to get to level 98. So still 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Still 5 levels away. That's too bad. Look at how fast everything's clicking. All right, so we're just going to traditional, standard, ranked, choose your fighter, Orzhov Troll Knights, and here we go. Okay. Yeah, those are the specs on the PC there. All right, yeah, y'all let me know in the stream, you know, how it's going and everything here. I have not tried a deck with Hushbringer and Troll together, no. Your last four matches were against Rakdos Knights. Hey, FlickerDocs, I'm doing great. Doing great. Really excited about having this new PC up and running. Let's kind of move this a little bit. And hoping all the settings are good. You know, on y'all on YouTube, let me know about like the sound settings and stuff too. I guess. Oh. Whoops. Stop. Okay. We have a new pet. New pet Cerebus. No more lands. I don't want lands. It's working. There's no changing in colors of Cerebus. Looks like he does some barking. Saltidor Neo. Hopefully that was pronounced correctly. Neo, thank you so much for the sub. Welcome to the channel. I guess I actually have to shock this thing in. Castle and Fabled Passage are both coming into play tapped. It's unfortunate because it looks like we're playing against Izzet Flash, and Izzet Flash does a good job of ending games kind of quickly with a lot of burn spells and things like that. They just do incidental damage, can play like a Brazen Borrower, get attacks in. It's not a deck that I really want to shock too much against. All right, I do know that I have a land down to the bottom, so this first shuffle isn't really helping that out too much, but oh well. My opponent's deciding that they don't want to play lands. They just want to have their two lands, and that's good enough for them. It's kind of a bold strategy, but they look like they're doing just fine. Yeah, usually this deck will have like an Embercleave in the sideboard. I'm not really expecting a main deck Embercleave. Just pull some more lands out. That's a lot of good cards I'm putting down to the bottom. Why couldn't we put like some extra lands down to the bottom? We just have to have all gas down there. Let's just try to go infinite with Acclaimed Contenders. Really? They had a Bonecrusher Giant and they didn't respond to the Acclaimed Contender? Do they not know how my cards work? Obviously, we're just going to draw lands now after putting all those spells to the bottom though too. Yeah, it's work. Everything's working great, Simon. I did see the new lands for the next set. They do look pretty sweet. Bonecrusher Giant's a good card. Keep killing all my creatures. Seriously, five spells again? The Balmarva Library is nothing but spells. I guess I need to save a Fable Passage. Ugh. What a beating. It's just all spells down there. Ugh, and then we're just going to draw lands. I need a higher bitrate. I can do that. I think. Perfect. My opponent probably doesn't think that that's perfect for me, but that's perfect for me. Well, it's not because the Acclaimed Contender is not going to trigger now, but... because basically we get to resolve Ethereal Absolution, which is good. We get to kill this Brineborn Cutthroat, which is good. Does anybody else know things about bitrate? And if I do need a higher one, anybody else, can somebody corroborate that story? Yeah, I don't know like those numbers, like what they do. Okay, so it doesn't look like. Alright, so yeah, I can't change that stuff whenever I'm streaming, but so I should change bitrate and my frames per second to 60. Gotcha. I'll write that down to change afterwards. For tomorrow's stream. Do I want to block here? Yeah. We can make like more creatures with this castle and stuff. This is really unfortunate. That we just put all the spells down to the bottom, and now we're just drawing all the lands. So I basically could only cast the Ethereal Absolution. You know, I have 9 mana. I could cast Absolution plus Contender, but Contender doesn't do anything right now without having another knight in play. I guess I should have left this back, I suppose. Rawr. Oh yeah, I could have played Wolf Tribal because of the new pet. They do have main board, that thing. So of course I could have Murderous Rider this, but let's get another planes because these castles. But the Knight of the Ebon Legion is always a little fragile. Maybe I should have just Murderous Ridered it though. We draw all the land because we put all the spells down to the bottom. But obviously we're doing just fine now that they tapped out for Embercleave. We got to resolve Ethereal Absolution, and everything's looking pretty good. Guess I just kill this thing right now. Okay, cool. I guess I have four friend requests. Or no, I have 4 friends online. I guess that means I have 4 friends online. No lag so far? Awesome. Okay, on our side, I don't have a ton of stuff that I want. Like, maybe Duress. Probably duress. Ethereal Absolution's kind of tricky. Like, it's really strong if it's in play. It's hard to get in play. They bounce. They do a lot of bouncing. So if I play these duresses, like Legion's End isn't too bad either because it just because of Cutthroat and how important Cutthroat is. If we play the duresses, we could go like take out a Troll, an Absolution, and probably one of these others. Like, I think we just keep in all this other stuff. Probably just another one of these. Maybe I just play two duress. I'm gonna take out a Paragon or a Knight. I'm gonna take out a Knight of the Ebon Legion. What? Yeah, don't. Why is it showing me that? I don't want. I understand. Yeah, Legion's End is really not bad because of how important Cutthroat is. So, Legion's End is not bad at all. I don't hate it. I don't have a fifth land, though. I think just kind of in general, it's not good to keep cards that you don't have enough lands to cast. But that's not always the case. You know, like there's some cards that are just too powerful that you want to keep and all that kind of stuff. We do need two more lands for Absolution right now. That'll help the contenders, like if they kill Knight of the Ebon Legion here. Alright, I don't think they have removal for Knight of the Ebon Legion. This is Time in a Bottle by Jim. I guess I don't know how to pronounce his last name. Croce? Croce? Crochet? Cross? I don't know. It's crotchy. Target a knight. Knight. Crochi. Yeah, so I didn't go Sorin minus three for Contender basically because I drew the Black Lance Paragon here. And so I was going to be able to double spell with Contender Paragon. But then, you know, the Contender found the Knight, which was even better. I don't really want to play something pre-combat now, though, because of Gadwick. And we'll also because of the Knight of the Ebon Legions. Primal Esper? I mean, like, what's Primal Esper, Kenpachi? Like, Primal Amulet in Historic? Hey, Azeroth. Yeah, new computer. We're on the new computer right now. Hey, Drug Wizard, thanks for the big cheer there. I appreciate that. Okay, so all these things are just lethal on their own. Let's see, if I Absolution, that's still 3 power, that's 2 power. What if I just want to, maybe I should just Sorin Contender. That still trades. Does force them to do blocking, though. All right, we'll do Absolution. Yeah, sure, Kenpachi. There you go, Drug Wizard, you got the cat? Awesome. Glad to hear. Okay, so they only blocked with one thing. Yeah, lag-free stream. Pretty ideal. Yep. What are the chances that Sorin resolves? Sorin could do 1 point of damage to them. Probably not good, right? Probably not good. So ideally we draw something that costs like 3 or less, that maybe they counter that, and then I get to play Sorin and they don't get to count, and then they don't counter Sorin. This is Churches. The song's Clearest Blue. Okay, another counterspell out of their hand. It's lethal though. I don't know. Is Deckmaster working for other people? As far as I know, it's up and working. As far as I know. It's not working? I don't know. Yeah, I don't know why Deckmaster would not be working. Is the Stream Decker working? I tried Cardboard Live. I emailed them, but they never emailed back. It's not something you can just download. But I mean, it's definitely like with the new PC, and like I have like some new settings. I don't think like Cardboard Live would necessarily just be working right now either. SD works confirmed. Stream Decker. Alright, how about Deckmaster now? The settings in Arena, I gotta change those. What is that settings? I think it's in the main screen, right? That's right. I forgot there's like that settings thing that you have to activate. Okay, it's in the main screen. All right, y'all remind me to do that. Yeah, Merfolk Kamikaze. That's what just happened there. All right, so of course I have like both Murderous Riders up here to kill this Gadwick on their end step, so they can't tap my Clackbridge Troll. That's my plan right now. So the cutthroat's a 2/1. Their creatures get -1/-1, so it enters as a 2/1. Well, it gets -1/-1, so it immediately dies. So it enters as a 1/0. You can't have a 0 toughness creature. Sorry, Kittles. All right, looks like my opponent is looking for a way to get out of this. Yeah, creatures, yes, the creatures do trigger ETB if they die to Absolution, because they enter the battlefield, they die right away to state-based actions, but they enter the battlefield. But if it does have an ETB effect, it'll still trigger because it did enter the battlefield. Yeah, looks like it's actually working. I'm so excited that it didn't lag a single time during the match, right? There's no lag. Graphics are better. Everything's working. Rawr, 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 rawr. We have a dog for a pet. We got puppy. Yes, rank reward. You get rank rewards for constructed, and you get rank rewards for limited. They're separate things. So if you are mythic in both, you'll get the rewards for mythic in both. Oh, this is like a new thing. This little dotted line thing. Okay, so there's like a setting over here. What do I have to go to? I think like account or something. Detailed logs. Okay, that's what I have to do. I think I have to do that. Okay, so now I think Deckmaster should be working. I guess we'll have to get into another match to find out. Oh, I need to restart client? No, cancel. All right, restart client. We are 1-0. And we're back at it. It's so nice, everything working. Yeah, I know lighting isn't the best. I'll figure out something with lighting. It feels like it's worse than what it was before. I don't know.
Who's that? Who's that? Is that Hawkeye? Is that Hawkeye?
You gonna come up here and say hi to everybody?
Hawkeye. How are you feeling, buddy? Feeling better?
I guess I should have used a Fable Passage turn one. Oh well. Hatred, thanks for that Twitch Prime sub. It says, how did the PC building experience go for you? And it went just fine. Went real well. You know, a couple of small hiccups every, you know, like here and there. But like one thing is I didn't have one of the four RAM sticks in all the way, and that puts a setback for a couple hours of like just Windows not loading. I couldn't figure it out. You just want to go up here. Well, good hand for the opponent. A lot of life loss for, you know, like we're already at 11. They haven't attacked us at all. Obviously, we really want to draw Ethereal Absolution. We'll start thinning the deck now with these Fabled Passages. Where are you going? Going back to your couch? Oh, I should have played the Fabled Passage. So there's just no real reason to attack there because they just block with the cat, then sacrifice. So they're gonna sacrifice the cat anyway. Played the wrong land. This is a great hand for them. They get to draw three cards with Korvold. Yuck. Dang, got punished for not playing the Fabled Passage and shuffling, drew another land. Four cards. Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm streaming higher than 1080p or not. I don't know. You guys have to tell me on your end. I don't know. Okay, it's 1080 because I thought Twitch only did 1080. Oh, that's what I read. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, they got this one. Yeah, their hand was really, really good. So they got it. So disenchant Kaya, couple Legion's Ends. Think Blacklands Paragon may be one of my weaker cards. I take out Blacklands Paragons, it kind of hurts Contender, though. So maybe take out one Contender, three Paragon. Yeah, Grasp and Dispark are both good against Korvold. I'd rather play Dispark because it hits murderous, or it hits, yeah, like basically Dispark just hits more than Grasp does. I mean, Grasp kills the goose though too. Bakaya does that, but I assume they have Golgari Queen. Yeah, I mean, if they have Korvold out, we're gonna die. So I should probably have another removal spell for a Korvold. I think I like Dispark more than Noxious Grasp. I guess the difference is Dispark hits. I guess Grasp is better. This hits Goose while this hits Massacre Girl. I guess there's just more Gooses in the deck. Thanks, Photogrind. Yeah, new PC is working good. Geese. That's the word. Geese. That's the word. Lovestruck Beast. We need to draw lands. Three lands, please. Whoa. Goose has a new animation. A good draw. They had two lands. And they not only drew a land, but it was a mountain. That worked out pretty well. I'm doing good, James. Thank you. Not too confident about getting this one here. Oh, I meant to Fabled Passage first, but I guess we're doing this anyway. Wasn't the worst draw. Yay, land. Yeah, that was my point, is I wanted to hold it to look for another land, but the reason to do it first was because of the Mayhem Devil, because whenever they played the Mayhem Devil. All right, now we got our six lands for the Absolution. Clear this up. We need cleanup on aisle two. Get those out of here. All right, well, that thing can't attack. Boom. Troll Absolution. Getting it done. All right, so they're playing those three mana 5/5s. May I just play another Noxious Grasp then? Paragon's good at blocking three mana 5/5s when they attack with them. Is it possible I'm supposed to be taking out Worthy Knight? Yeah, I mean, Dress has a ton of hits. I don't know if I can really play it, though. I think I just need to keep affecting the battlefield. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with Dress in this matchup for like other decks, but I just want to play this other stuff. Twenty-six lands in the deck. Because we need to hit six land drops to get to Absolution, so we gotta have enough land. And then, of course, both castles let us do stuff when we have extra mana anyway. Both the white and the black castle are both good at castles to have. Thrashing Brontodon.
Nothing phases me.
The problem is I'm just gonna let Kaya die now, I think. Could really use another black source, obviously. Hey Yud. Yeah, everything's going really well. This is like a friends list thing. Gosh, need more black mana. Yeah, Wicked Wolf was a reason to play Despark, I suppose. obviously we draw this when they have Mayhem Devil. This pet was in the store. It was a lot of... It was just a bunch of gold. I think it was 20,000 gold, I think. Down to 12. If they have another land, they can make a food, play the Wicked Wolf, sack the food, kill my Knight of the Ebon Legion. It's fine. Let's get this thing in play. No, so yeah, so I killed the Brontodon, so the Brontodon couldn't kill the Absolution. Beanstalk Giant. That card's pretty good. I, of course, have to kill this goose. Best draw would be another Absolution. They would just kill the goose. But obviously, I just need to kill this goose. I can also just exile. I get to exile the familiar from the graveyard, though, too. Just a tough spot. Hey, what's up, Dennis? Thank you so much for the Twitch Prime sub. Thanks for resubbing. Yeah, lag free. I don't know. Let's just play this thing. Like, we have to kill both of these. I don't know. Could hold a rider mana. I guess, you know, like doing this. Well, I'm glad we exiled the thing we needed to exile. At least. This goose is just gonna kill me. Yeah, casualty's real good. Trailer crumbs are just kind of too good. It's tough beating these trailer crumbs for sure. Yeah, it's just... too hard to outgrind these trailer crumbs. Want a slice of pepperoni sausage bacon pizza? Not too much. I think that's too much. It's too much like fatty meats for me. I like pepperoni on my pizza. Sausage is kind of meh, like I'll eat it. Bacon is a little too much. All right, we're 1-1. It's almost 5 o'clock, we've only played 2 games. Usually I'd be streaming for 2 hours. We've only played 2 matches now. We need to move on. Was that only the second match, or did... Are we 2-1 now, or are we only 1-1? We beat the Flash deck. Did we beat something else? Or did we just play Flash and then that? Yeah, we've been streaming for an hour. Good. Maybe, yeah, glad you're liking the stream a lot better now. Dang, standard is still as slow as ever. It wasn't just the computer. That's correct, Baki. Yep. Clackbridge Troll is our troll in our troll deck. I wasn't sure what was Stomping Ground Forest, Scorching Dragonfire. That's a good draw. Gets a double spell with the Acclaimed Contender. These are both good cards. I'm not sure. That's tough. Yep, that's correct. Yeah, Citadel's in the board for the control matchup. Basically, Absolution doesn't do... Like, against non-creature decks, you don't really need Absolution, so you board out Absolution and you bring in Citadel. Against decks that aren't playing very many creatures. Huh. So the new rig's going great. Yeah, everything's good. Everything's good. Rawr, rawr, rawr. Yeah, Cerebus is a new pet from today, from the update for today. Thank you, Carbon Required. I don't think anybody told me. Yeah, I'm glad Deckmaster is working now. Good, good. I need to update that. I need to change that setting there. Yeah, it's Puppy and Harvey, and yeah, I don't know who the third head, what the third head is. Maybe it's just Hawkeye. Getting to be a dog. Great, yeah, PC's going great. He slept for 3 to 4 hours, went to sleep another an hour later, and then slept for 8+ more hours. I can understand that. I'm pretty worn out right now after the last couple of days. I've done a lot of trips into town and, you know, get this park at that park, that kind of stuff, and the building and everything. I'm pretty worn out. No, Hushbringer would be awful in this deck. It would stop a claim contender, and most importantly, it stops Midnight Reaper. Could not play Hushbringer in this deck. Oh wait, they didn't do anything, and then I didn't attack? Huh, I should have attacked. Yeah, definitely should have attacked. Maybe not. Anyway, I need one more land. I need to get to this Ethereal Absolution, of course. Doesn't kill a ton of stuff for them right now. Look, all this, all these twos. Darn, they're doing the damage at me. I was definitely hoping they were going to just kill one of my creatures with all that damage there. Kinda need to play Sorin also though. Man, Risen Reef is so good. That was a heck of a turn. Most likely dead. I would assume they have another Neoform or an Omnath, either one to kill me. Yeah, you'd have to play a lot different deck to play Hushbringer. Just wouldn't play these knights. Unfortunately, I only have two removal spells for Risen Reef. As we saw there, Risen Reef is just Risen Reef is the card. And so that's why getting to Absolution to kill other Risen Reefs as soon as they come in. I only have two more with the Noxious Grasps. Yeah, sure. I guess, yeah, Hushbringer is good against Elementals for the one time every other week you play against Elementals. I don't think I want to Spark or Legion's End. Legion's End would be good. Okay. Guess I'm gonna need that. I guess I'm gonna need land drops. So Worthy Knight would help me go wide, where Murderous Rider would be able to kill a Risen Reef. I guess we gotta just kill Risen Reef. Cause it's just the single card that makes my opponent's deck really good. Without Risen Reef, their deck isn't very good, but they are good at finding Risen Reef. And getting it back, you know, like with the two drop, they can bring it back for a little bit and stuff like that. Like they're and Neoform to go find it, like. It's not like, so basically what I'm saying is one, just having a removal spell for Risen Reef isn't gonna always save you. But my opponent had multiple Risen Reefs both these games, and that's a little unfortunate for me. Oh! Darn, I did not play Troll. Meant to. Yeah, new PC is working perfectly. Obviously, I meant to do that pre-combat. Just perfect. Oh, Risen Reef, how busted you are. I've gone through 9 more cards now. Of course, the Neoform Risen Reef is a 2-2, so it doesn't die, unfortunately. All right, so what can they do? Yeah, we got to hit our land drops this time. Got to Absolution there. What? Return to Nature?
Living in a monastery full of firebrands? Say hi to my fiery
I guess friends. They knew my deck had Ethereal Absolution, I guess. I didn't even play it last game. But maybe they played against a deck like this before. It's possible. They weren't dead. No, like, so they could have sacrificed one of their two creatures to the troll to tap the troll. And then block one of my other, and then block the Knight of the Ebon Legion. Oh, wait. They were at three, and wait, were all my creatures lethal? I guess the other creature was lethal, too. Never mind, they were dead. Never mind. I was thinking they needed two. I needed two creatures to connect. No, I guess it was just one. My bad, my bad. Alright, well, this hand is not beating their best hands. Yeah, we were in game two. There, Gomas. We were in game two. Hopefully they don't have multiple Risen Reefs for a chance. Or for a change. Please not another Risen Reef. So why am I not playing Kaya to exile the elementals in the graveyard? Even though that does, like, all that, yeah, that does stop Thunderkin Awakener's ability. But I need to focus more on winning the battlefield, I think, than worrying about, you know, using three mana in a card just to stop the ability of one of their cards. That's the only thing that does. That was a great turn. No more elementals. Keep exiling my Midnight Reapers. Obviously, with them drawing two cards a turn, this is is not going to work out for me for too much longer. Thanks, Orange. Yeah, as far as I can tell, everything with the new PC is working really well. And so, definitely excited about that. I am back. Not looking good with this match. Looks like we're losing this one. They've gone again another 8 cards by turn 6 in their deck. Try going real wide. Yeah, J45, the freeze that was my old computer was dying. But that should all be done with now. Now we have the new computer working and everything. Thanks, Arcane Fox. Yeah, Arena has a friends list now. No, I did not change this deck at all since the last time we played. Disdainful Stroke. Probably have another Disdainful Stroke in hand. That would make sense. You know, they discard one, keep another one. They're just like, you know, keeping cards in hand that they weren't playing. That also makes sense that they have another counterspell. Fires, Clackbridge Troll, single combat. How's that a good combo? Single combat is you can only choose one creature. Millions of lands. Zola. I could do this all day. Of course, the problem is surviving Cavalier of Flame. I could have played Sorin and been able to gain a good amount of life, but again, I think that they have another Disdainful Stroke. And so I went with the Contender, I was hoping to hit another Murderous Rider with it. Because, yeah, obviously this Cavalier of Flame Embercleave combo is really rough, but I mean, my opponent's just had millions of Risen Reef activations. This is just kind of over. They've drawn 14 more cards. Obviously, 14 more cards to kind of do it. Yeah, so single combat. I mean, all it does is basically just get rid of the tokens. Bum. You just put Embercleave on Cloud Conceer, activate. Like, I was just dead on board. Just put it on Cloud Conceer, activate the Cavalier of Flame a few times. It's possible they didn't see that, but I mean, it's just, we're not winning that. It was a lost game. It's tough to beat all those Risen Reef activations. Single combat with Brought Back. Put those two together in a deck. Certainly want to put in a good amount of ETB effects as well. Combine with those. Hey, Snow. So yeah, with what my opponent's playing, this is definitely like I thought this was gonna be like a Nissa deck. So I want the extra Murderous Rider. Yep. I was hoping they were going to play Nissa, not Cavalier of Thorns, though. This was kind of worst-case scenario. Cavalier of Thorns that milled over another Cavalier of Thorns. That's pretty rough. Thank you. I really like Agent of Treachery is such a problem. I've been good against Agent of Treachery. Card's such a problem. There's a lot of Simic in this metagame now. Yeah, I'd probably have to change something up for Simic. This has never been a great matchup with Agent of Treachery. Agent of Treachery quasi duplicate. Like, you know, like we could have obviously we weren't dead right there. We could continue to play it out, but all the permutations were just us losing. Because of course I have to kill the Agent of Treachery because they're going to quasi-duplicate the Agent of Treachery, so I have to kill that thing. Obviously the 5-6 is just beating us down, so I have to kill that thing. They're going to get another 5-6 back, or the Agent of Treachery back, depending on if I kill Agent of Treachery first, then whenever I kill the 5-6, they get the Agent of Treachery back. Yeah, we probably gotta do something else against Simic here. No, I just have one PC F Doom. I would really like to activate Knight to be able to start growing them, but if there's another Cavalier of Thorn, I think I need to be able to Noxious Grasp it in response to the ETB effect again, so they don't get anything back.
I protect that which cannot protect itself. Harness the elements.
Hey, Andrew. Hmm. little worried about Agent of Treachery here, but I mean, I guess we're probably just losing to Agent of Treachery anyway. And I shouldn't be worried about it. Should have just played the troll last turn. So obviously, what we need to draw are absolutions. Like, that's just what we need. Like, ethereal absolutions will get us there over time.
Rise, my elemental friend.
Just gotta draw absolutions. The more, the better. Gotta get these lands out of here before they're indestructible. Well, there we go. Kaios! Thanks for that Twitch Prime sub. This song is 21 Pilots Holding On to You, is the name of the song. Thanks, Kaios. Thanks for resubbing there. Where are my hype boats at? There they are. That is our ninth sub of the day. Yes, it is. Yep. I am not behind. Look at that. Back down to six, but again, troll, Clackbridge Troll can have us gain life. We can also use the Paragon on an activated knight to gain some life. Yeah, they probably should have just cast this first. They would have gotten another. They would have drawn another card, gained another life. Would have made it an 8/8. They would have done that first. Obviously, we drew the Worthy Knight at a little bit of an unfortunate time. Off the Clackbridge Troll, where I don't get to play that before the Paragon. We're at a nice healthy life total now, the 14. Definitely wish I would have played the troll a turn before I did. I'd rather my opponent draw Nissa's than draw Agent of Treacheries. Behold, nature's true power. They could still cast Agent of Treachery. Sauron, we're supposed to play you pre-combat also. Okay, yeah, that by sacking there, like, I just have lethal here. Both knights are lethal on their own. I don't mind fighting through Nissa's. They're not as bad to fight through, as you could tell. Yeah, I got the new computer. It's all working and everything. Yeah, it's going. It's great, Rankler. Yeah, no lag problems at all. I'm playing in 1440. I think I'm recording in 1440 as well for YouTube, I think. So yeah, everything's working well. The main thing is if I try to play Worthy Knight first and then play Knight of the Ebon Legions. And I think I do. Because we've seen them play a bunch of like O3s and just like little things that just chump block the knights. That's a really, really awkward land to draw. The plains. I wish I led with the castle Lochtwain instead of the castle Ardenvale, obviously. It's awkward. They got Nissa, and I'm like, well, I can try to play my one drops now. Okay, there we go. That's better. Get out of here, Nissa. Ow. Absolution doesn't really do too much for us right here. I kind of like being able to hold up the Knight activation and the Murderous Rider. Again. We're going to need to draw some life gain up in here. We're going to need to get some life gain. Yeah, new PC. It all works. The real problem is that they do have Agent of Treachery. Like, this is the problem. Because if they have Agent of Treachery, I'm in huge trouble. Because obviously they steal Absolution. They've just been holding agent and waiting. I could be like, this game could just be over. Please not just pass. They're not slamming it. Uh-oh. Trample. Okay. My opponent decided for the more boring play with the end race four runners. I think I want to keep both my Knight of the Ebon Legions alive. All right, looking good. Yeah, no Agent of Treachery.
We lived. We lived.
Easy peasy. All right. So we went 2-2. Nothing wrong with 2-2. But of course we're gonna have to move on to get to the other decks. We may only have three decks tonight anyway, but we're gonna try to get to the four. We noticed that there's, you know, more enchantment hate, casualties of war, return to nature, stuff like that, that definitely hurt. That's the thing about Ethereal Absolution, is it's the more enchantment hate people are playing, the worse it is for you. Even, you know, Agent of Treachery kind of counts there with the enchantment hate also. So definitely ran into more enchantment hate, which was a problem. That was kind of about it, though. I don't hate the Jund Sacrifice matchup. What's up, Clear Haze? But we're not always going to win it. Like, Jund Sacrifice is a really strong deck, and my opponent had really strong draws. Undo that. Why did that do that? The games that they won. Ooh, that's our first sub goal of the day. Got there. Yeah, nothing really that I necessarily want to change after those four games. I think I'd want to play some more and kind of see from there, but like how it really fits in with the newer metagame. But still felt pretty good. And every time Ethereal Absolution we got to play it and it got to stick, it was awesome, of course. That's the thing, is getting it to stick with all these enchantments running around. Suvisac! Thanks, Suvisac, for the tier 1 sub and S Beta also. Y'all are awesome. Thank you so much. But for now, let's go ahead and end this one up. So, yeah, it seems like my lighting is worse than it was before, isn't it? With my camera. I'll figure that out eventually, but oh well. There we go. That's Orzhov Troll Knights. Y'all on YouTube, you know, hit that like button over there. Of course, leave the comments. Let me know if the video's better, all that kind of stuff. Just leave some comments. I would appreciate it. But thank you so much for watching some Orzhov Troll Knights, and I'll see you for the next video.